So what's next, John?
The schoolhouse, perhaps.
The landmark building of Georgeville, for sure.
It is the most photographed building in Georgeville.
That's right. The most painted.
Yes.
John, there is a date over the door.
That's the year that this original schoolhouse, built in 1829, burned to the ground. And this was built to replace it. Built as a school, but probably with the thought in mind that it would be used as a community building. I went to school in the Red Schoolhouse for my first 6 years. My birthday is in October, and I understood that you started school when you were 6 years old. So I refused to come to school until my birthday. Apparently the teachers thought it was all right for me to start late.
Oh dear. When did it go out of service as a school?
It became the community hall when the consolidated school was built across the road here in 1934. The builder came from Friedlisburg, and Arlie Davidson, who was the contractor in the village, was quite put out. I graduated from here to the consolidated school. And then when they closed the consolidated school and took children to Magog, the community center was moved to the abandoned consolidated school. The Red Schoolhouse is now owned by Toby Rochester. He bought the schoolhouse after it had been in use for 10 or 15 years as the community hall.
And this was a derelict building. It had the kitchen at the back that was on posts, and the sink used to just empty onto the ground underneath. And Judy said, "Let's buy it." And I said, "Are you crazy? It wasn't a house, it wasn't anything. The roof leaked, the upstairs was full of bats." Anyway, she was very convincing, and so we bought it and began to convert it into a house. And we had little money at the time, but we were full of enthusiasm. But the thing that really intrigued us was that the frame of the building was made of hand-hewn timbers, so we could see a potential nice home. But you really had to stretch your imagination because there wasn't much in there. So it took us 10 years to actually turn it into a really quite a comfortable house. As I was working on it, I got a little, the house was originally white. All the buildings in Georgeville were white. And I flicked off a piece of paint and I saw the original schoolhouse red. So I took a sample of that. I was with the DuPont Company at the time, and I took it back to our labs in Montreal. And they produced a color for me, or they gave me a color chip, and I went and had it so it would be exactly the same color as it originally was. The day we started to paint it red, the village was split down the middle. The locals liked it white because it matched all the other buildings. Now we were converting it back to red. There was great discussion over it, but I was going to forge ahead. I wanted to restore it to what it looked like originally from the old photographs that we still see hung around the village. And this is one of them. This is the class of 1905, I think. And John, do you recognize anybody in there that...
I wasn't around in 1905.
No. And the whole idea was to restore it back to its visual beauty of 1848, I think it was started and finished in 1849. Once it was finished, I think everybody was absolutely enthralled, you know, that it had been returned to its original color.
Yeah.
I think we've done a fairly good job restoring it. We got the bell, the clock, and the original lighting. So that's the story of the schoolhouse.